Muhterem Reis, Muhterem
Excellency Chairperson,
Executive
Secretary of the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific, ladies and gentlemen, I at the onset would like to extend deep appreciation to Ms. Armida Salsia Jahbano, Executive Secretary of the United Nations Economic and Social Commission for Asia and the Pacific, for convening the high-level meeting. Today's event is very important and timely, given the current threats and the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, which is still ongoing in many countries worldwide. These days, no country or industry in the world is immune from the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic. At the same time, the pandemic is a factor in the unprecedented rise in global unemployment, which could leave many countries with food insecurity. Although, according to the World Health Organization, the approximate death toll from this disease is known, the financial and economic impacts of the COVID-19 are yet to be fully assessed. Distinguished Chairperson, the global intensification of the COVID-19 pandemic has forced us to take specific measures in our country to prevent this disease, mitigate socio-economic damage, and support vital sectors of society. We have revised the public budget for 2020, taking into account the reduction of budget revenues and the growing demand for funding social sector, particularly healthcare and other unforeseen spending, and made relevant amendments in the revenue, expenses, and deficit indicators, including more than 30 hospitals with 7,000 beds and 5,400 doctors and medical staff have been mobilized in the country for the full and timely treatment of people with infectious diseases, COVID-19. 16,000 beds were prepared in 92 hospitals and medical institutions. Additional financial resources were allocated from the state budget to the health sector to purchase medical equipment and medicines and for the construction of temporary hospitals and the support of medical personnel. To support the private sector, significant tax and credit benefits, privilege and compensation had been provided to our entrepreneurs and small and medium businesses. Social benefits were paid to vulnerable groups of the population during the pandemic. Over 193,000 permanent and seasonal jobs were created during this period of time. To ensure food security in the country and increase level of domestic production, the field of the main sowing and reproduction of agricultural crops has been increased to tens of thousands of hectares. Given our social-oriented public budget, 48% of the budget expenses last year has been allocated for the social sector. Furthermore, to eliminate the consequences of the COVID-19 pandemic, the government of Tajikistan has expanded productive cooperation with development partners, in particular with the International Monetary Fund,
the World Bank,
the Asian Development Bank, and other international financial institutions. Taking this opportunity, I would like to express profound gratitude to all states and international organizations, including the United Nations and its specialized agencies, particularly the World Health Organization, development partners, international and regional financial institutions for support they gave Tajikistan during the pandemic. Distinguished Chairperson, it is essential to note that regardless of measures taken by the government, the economy of the Republic of Tajikistan still suffers from the consequences of the COVID-19 pandemic. Although no case of COVID-19 infectious disease has been registered across Tajikistan since the beginning of the year.
Therefore,
the post-COVID-19 period economic recovery, stimulation of small and medium-sized businesses, support of vulnerable group of population, implementation of anti-epidemiological measures, particularly immunization programs from all countries, including the Asia-Pacific region, require additional financial resources. In this situation, countries of our region, along with extending social protection, need to invest in sustainable economic recovery, supporting trade, ensuring the smooth transportation of essential items, in particular food and medicine, and protecting the environment. Counter possible future threats and crises, diversify the economy, promote the digitalization process, adapt to the climate change, and foster transition to the green economy. In these sensitive and challenging time, coordinated actions and mutual support are essential for the entire global community. I thank you for your attention.